Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about what things we'd need to know if you are going to be doing a case where you're going to be doing some type of anterior restorative work, be it 7 through 10, 2 to 2, upper 2s only, 7 and 10, and what we need to know to help you optimize that ClinCheck or that aligner setup so that you could have a great restorative outcome. Now, keep in mind, I am an orthodontist. I'm not a restorative dentist. I think I was one for one day until I started my residency in ortho. So have I even done veneers on, we can't remember. I probably did in dental school. I don't remember. But I've certainly set up a heck of a lot of anterior restorative cases for general dentists. So the way it works when you're an orthodontist and you're working in an office is that you're going to be communicating with the referring general dentist to try to make sure, and then the general dentist is communicating with their lab. So there's three different people and the patient. So there's four different people communicating to make sure we have everything set up for the best possible outcome. Listen, I'm not driving the boat here, y'all are. You're the one who decides, am I gonna do 2 veneers, 4 veneers, 6 veneers, 8 veneers? You're the one that decides how much clearance you want, anterior to posterior in a sad little direction. You know, usually you need some type of overjet. Some people like 1 millimeter, some people like 1.5, some people like 2. That's up to you, okay? If you're not sure, ask your lab. It's up to you how you want the space distributed. So some people like it equally distributed if they're doing the 4 veneers or the 6 veneers. Some people, if they're just doing 2 veneers on 7 and 10, upper 2s, they want 1/3 mesial, 2/3 distal. Sometimes they want half-half. I don't know what you want. So if you're going to give me a case and you're telling me we're going to be doing restorative work, I'm going to need this information from you. So since I get kind of tired of typing it out, it seems to be an issue that comes up almost every day, I'm going to go ahead and make this video. So from now on, if you're telling me you're going to do restorations on front teeth, this is the information that I need. How do you want to get clearance? And how much clearance? So do you want to get it with lower incisor extraction? Do you want to get it with sequential distalization? We can't do that if there's impacted molars. We can't do that if the patient's already class 1. We can do that if the patient is class 3. Do you want to do it with a ton of IPR? Remember, when you do a ton of IPR, that means a ton of refinements usually, because it's very difficult to get IPR accurate. Really nobody can do it. There's no accurate way to do it right now. So just, it's going to take a lot of reboots. So it's going to make, even though the plan may say it's 40 aligners, it's going to be 100 aligners when it's all said and done, probably. So that's always the least accurate and the longest way to get there is the tons of IPR method. So we need to know that, okay? There's no way around this. You got to tell us what you want. You got to be specific which teeth are getting restored. I want to know how many and which ones. And you got to be specific on how you want the space distributed. I highly, highly recommend that you use the export STL feature that's in your ClinCheck. If you don't know how to use that, you can go to my YouTube channel. You can put in my YouTube channel, which is Straight Smile Solutions, export STL, or virtual lab wax up or something like that. And it'll bring up how to do that. Communicate with your lab because it makes no sense to do it the way you think you're doing it. And then the lab goes, oh no, we need things differently. Now, it gets even more complicated if let's say it's an implant or something. And let's say you're not the one placing the implant. You might be the one restoring the implant. Now we have a fifth person involved, and that's going to be the periodontist or the oral surgeon, usually a periodontist I recommend. We got to get their feedback on how they want things to be. And of course, the patient needs to be involved. Now, number one tip I can give you in terms of anterior restorative cases, interdisciplinary cases where ortho is involved, the lab's involved, the specialty dentist is involved, the general dentist is involved, the patient's involved. Number one is make sure your patient's on board with this. Patients normally will be, yeah, I want to do this. But when it all comes to the end and then all of a sudden they're like, yeah, I can't afford this. You really, really want to bundle this all into one complex treatment plan that includes the ortho, that includes the restorative. Make sure they're putting deposits down and everything. Make sure before you even pull the trigger on the Invisalign or the ClearCorrect or whatever you're doing to get anterior alignment, that they're already doing the virtual wax up. They're already committed to it. They already put a deposit on it. They already signed off on the treatment plan. That way, you know for sure the treatment plan is a go. I would highly, highly, highly recommend you never do a case like this unless the patient has not only signed the treatment plan, but that means nothing, but also committed to it financially. However you want to do that, okay? Because why? Because every time you don't do that, it usually falls apart. And at the end, they're like, oh, I changed my mind. I want to have all the space closed. Can we just do that? And now we have to completely reboot the whole case and take it in a whole different direction. It's another year and a half, 2 years. And everyone's mad and frustrated. So that is the why behind that. And hey, if you're a lab technician and you're getting this, you're seeing this this YouTube video and you want to give in feedback, I'm super excited to see your feedback below. Feel free to leave your feedback in the comments section. We definitely check and read every single comment that's out there. If you're a restorative dentist, I would love also to hear your feedback. All right, thanks so much.